You guys think you see something in the woods off to the side, and you stop for a second and wait, but there doesn't seem to be anything there.
Yeah, oh boy.
So then you guys continue on, and I need you all to roll stealth checks again.
23.
13.
I rolled a 15 plus 5, 20.
11.
I'm so screwed. My rolls have been killer. We're going to get in battle and I'm going to be like 1, 1, 2, 1.
Okay. You guys keep continuing. A lot quieter now.
See this level of quiet? We could have been this level of quiet all the time.
You guys continue traveling through the woods. I need you guys to roll another set of stealth checks.
What
one is this?
Stealth.
Well, 7 plus 5 is 12.
4.
How am I the stealthiest one?
You wear less armor than I do.
I'm a Goliath.
Yeah, but you wear less armor than I do.
Yeah, but I'm stealth. You guys both rolled a 12. The other, Midori.
No, I rolled a 6. I get adds.
Yeah, but it came out to a 12.
Yeah.
I'm saying.
I rolled a 7. 5.
Yeah, I'm saying I'm stealthier right now than like, the rogue.
Oh, really?
This doesn't bode well.
Yeah, he tripped over a rock. It was all right.
Apparently, the alcohol had more of an effect on a smaller person. Oh, boy.
Long pause equals. All right. So roll a.
Yeah, pretty much roll initiative, guys.
Oh, shit.
Got a 15 for initiative.
I got a 19.
What's initiative thing?
Your just... d20 plus your dex modifier.
Who? Thank God for dex.
Harley, what did you get?
15.
Robot.
Sorry, I was hacking up a loogie. I rolled 14. Loogie!
And then, Dagon, what did you get?
7.
What?
I rolled a 3 plus 4. 7.
Well, I don't think I have to worry about it next week. I think we're going to die with these rolls.
I told you, as soon as we get to combat, I'm effed.
You had too much alcohol last night at the camp.
So what do I add to this? I rolled a 14 plus what?
Your dexterity.
Dex is a modifier.
Okay, so 3. So 17. I rolled a 17. Okay, no, that's on saving throw. Okay, so just a modifier. Okay. So 17. And I have stout resilience against poison and yeah.
Why would you ever have to mention that?
Just saying, I'm just throwing that out. So. Long pause, never good. Long pause, never good.
Yeah, I gotta set everything up.
Oh no. We're fighting Shelob.
She-Ra. Dun, dun,
dun, dun, She-Lob and all of her children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren.
Shut up. I blame you clanking through the woods.
I was trying my best.
All right, link to the maps in Discord chat. And you guys attract the attention of three giant spiders that are the appropriate size this time.
Okay, that's Yay. Fair enough.
They're huge.
No, they're large.
You know, it's not, size doesn't matter, it's the motion in the ocean.
Let's not get pulled down any holes.
I don't know what kind of freakiness that is, but yeah.
Let's... Well, I guess that would be metagaming, so...
Can't we talk amongst ourselves? Like, stick together!
So, what was the order?
I think he's still figuring that out, including the spiders.
Yeah, gotta do that.
I think out of us, I rolled a 19, so I think out of us, I'm going first, but yeah, I don't know how the spiders are.
Did we have a silence thing? Didn't I have a spell for that? I don't know. I should have used that. No.
Hey, Dale, heads or tails?
Tails.
A man after my heart. Tap that tail. Damn it.
All right.
He met dun, 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 the power of Grayskull. He-Man would always do a He-Man roll at the end of a jump. He could jump off a cliff and do a He-Man roll.
It is two of the spiders' turn first.
Oh boy.
Because they rolled really well.
Oh boy.
Do we have a map for this, or are we on this road or something?
Yeah, you put a link in.
Sorry, I labeled them this time, just so I can keep track of their positions. So, giant spider number one.
GS stands for godly or goodly.
I hope not.
Stands for giant spider. And it approaches Deo. And it's gonna bite him.
Bring it.
But I don't think a 15. Does a 15 hit you, Dale?
Oh, yeah. I only have a 13.
Oh, okay. That's right. It's Arlie who's really tanky.
Yep. And she's in the back.
All right. You take 10 points of piercing damage, and I need you to make a constitution saving throw.
Okay, if we can...
The Constitution?
Yep, Constitution saving throw.
19.
Okay, you're fine.
Ooh,
well, you're not poisoned, but you take an additional 5 damage. Poison damage.
On top of the 10.
On top of the 10.
Ay, ay, ay. Okay.
Giant spider number two is going to move a little bit closer, and it's going to shoot a web at you.
Seeing if I have any resistance to... Would that be a grapple?
No.
Oh.
And unfortunately, you manage to duck, and the webbing it shoots out goes right over your head. But as it falls, it kind of like drapes over you, but it's not restraining you or anything.
But it gives me armor, right?
Spunk in your head.
Dang. All right, now it's your turn, Dale.
Well, I'm going to turn to the giant spider one and give it a swing with my axe.
All right.
Okay, so. And I just add my attack bonus, right, to my d20.
Yeah, roll d20, add attack bonus.
Okay. Then that would be 24.
Yeah, that hits.
Nice. 1d12. Nine, 10, 14 damage.
Okay.
And can't really do anything else. I mean, that would be beneficial. So I'll end my turn there.
Alrighty. It's now giant spider number 3's turn. He's gonna move there and he's gonna shoot a web at you again since you're in front. And he hits.
Crap.
You are restrained by the webbing.
Yay.
Well, see you later, buddy.
Screw you.
And just so you know, restrain means your speed is becomes zero. And you can't benefit from any bonus to its speed. Attack rolls against you have advantage. And your attacks have disadvantage.
But I can break out of it.
Yeah, you can take your action to break out of it.
Okay.
And you also have disadvantage on dexterity saving throws.
Oh, okay.
And next up is Robot's turn.
All right, so okay, I think I want to go to... I want to kill GS1 because it's in range. And but I want to... So I got... On my shatter, I've got 20... What's it? 20 meters? 20 feet?
I don't know.
I forget.
Burn your spells.
Learn your spell, son.
What spell is it?
Shatter.
It's a range of 60 feet and it has a 10-foot radius centered around a point.
Yeah, so I want to get them all clumped up, and but they're like number 3 and number 2 are. I don't think they're in range. One of those squares is what, 5 feet, 10 feet?
5 feet.
All Okay, so
pretty much be hitting in a block that's as big as the spider.
Okay. So I gotta get them right next to each other to, like, hit two or three of them. All right, so I'm gonna lean over to the side and I'm gonna move to my right and shoot the G1 with my crossbow, I think.
All right.
There and shoot the G1 with the crossbow. And that's going to be a D20, right?
Yep, D20 plus your attack bonus.
Ah, crap, I rolled an 8. Plus attack bonus is... Plus 6. So that's, 14?
You just barely hit.
Ooh. And D6 plus 4. So I rolled a 2 plus 4 is 6 damage.
Alrighty. It's looking a little rough, but still up. Anything else you want to do? Inspire anybody?
I'll inspire Arlie.
Yay!
How are you going to inspire her?
So, yeah. So I'll give her inspiration. And I say, you can do it! What's your name? Sariel?
Yep, Sariel.
You can do it, Sariel! Make sure your fireballs hit true and stuff.
Okay. Oh, what does it do?
You gain 1d6 inspiration. You can add it to any ability check, saving throw, or attack roll.
Is that like once per turn, or is it just once?
Just once. Okay. Plus, he inspires you again, and you get another one.
Okay, cool.
But you can only have one inspiration dice at a time.
Yeah. Okay.
All right, that ends your turn, robot?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, Harley, you're up.
Was it the giant spider one that was looking like it was hurting a lot?
Mm-hmm. Yep. It's okay. The only one that's been damaged.
All right. First thing I do, I'm going to cast Shield of Faith on Deo, which gives you plus 2 bonus to AC.
Woohoo.
That takes a bonus action. So that's done. And then I'm going to move up to Great Spider 1 and try and stab it with my sword.
All right.
Right for the eyes. Does a 17 hit it?
Yes, 17 does.
Yay! Because if not, I'd be like, nice knowing you guys, bye.
Try to grab her with my teeth. You're not going anywhere.
I always want to say that my weapon is a 1d12 for some reason. I always have that stuck in my head.
Jeez, that'd be insane, a one-hander.
Yeah.
Yeah, not happening.
So 8 more points of damage to that spider.
How do you want to kill it?
I want to chop its eyes off.
All of them?
Jeez. A nice flick of her rapier, she just like slices just behind all the eyes, and just like the whole front of the spider's head just slides off.
Ha ha!
Exposing a gooey, weeping like hole.
And that's my turn.
All right, Dagon, you're up.
Yay!
Spider one is no longer there.
All right. I am going to. Far away. I'm close enough to shoot that thing with the bow, right?
Yeah. It's only 20 feet away from.
Close enough to get your good buddy out of webbing.
I want to shoot it the spider number two. Spider number two hasn't done anything yet, right?
He tried to shoot the webbing but missed. Yeah. But yeah. Three got me.
So all of them will move. Alright, well, I'm still going to try to shoot him, but I guess I get disadvantage, right?
Yes, you do.
And what's that do? I have to roll twice and take the
roll lower? Roll twice, take the lower one. Then add your proficiency, your attack bonus.
Oh, crap. Well, this is going to be funny. Natural one.
As you try and take a shot with this one, you just get like, why am I using this damn thing? And then you just launch the arrow up, like straight up in the air.
Wait, how straight up in the air?
Not like straight up in the air, but like almost straight up in the air.
I mean, angled enough that it's falling on me? I'm kind of stuck.
No, he's
I don't care about him.
The direction is more towards the giant spider.
Okay.
Awesome. Yeah, I mean, I guess that's my turn then.
All right. So, top of the order again. Oh, giant spider number two's turn. Let's see if he gets his webbing back. He does.
How rude.
I think this time he's a web again, and he's gonna this time aim for Dagon.
Damn it, knew I should have moved backwards.
Does a 15 hit.
I have 15.
So yeah, it makes it.
Oh.
You are restrained by webbing.
Son of a... Hey man, I'm stuck too. What's up? Web bros for life.
I hate you.
So your speed is 0. Attack rolls against you have advantage. You have disadvantage. And you have disadvantage on dexterity saving throws.
Awesome.
All right, Dale, you're up.
Well, to break out of it, it's an action, right?
Yes, it uses your action.
Okay, then I'll break out of it.
All right, I need you to make a strength check.
18 total. Or wait, no, sorry. It's not a saving throw, so 16 total, my bad.
All right, and you still manage to break out of the weapon.
Okay. Now, is it a...
Yeah.
Huh?
You have your movement, and you have your bonus action.
Would me...
Run right between...
Hmm?
Run right between them so you can gather them together so I can shoot them with the shatter.
I'm good, because I learned from last time they apparently have holes. We're trying to stick together. Can I... Would it be a bonus action to try to get Zavok out? Or, sorry, Dagon? Or is that an action?
That would be an action.
Yeah. I'll move so I'm in front of Dagon. And I just go to the spiders and end my turn.
Okay. Giant Spider 3, let's see if he gets his webbing back. He doesn't.
Of course. Oh, he doesn't. Yeah, screw you. Ah, crap. Frozen in time. Oh, sorry.
Right there.
Okay. Oh. Uh-oh.
And that's going to be its turn. Then, Robot, you're up.
Hey, hey, hey. So, wow, okay, move that close. And who's the green? That's Arlie?
Yeah.
Okay, so... And my shatter only works in the range of the spider, right? So it won't go beyond that, right?
If you're aiming right for the center of them, they're 10 feet.
Like, yeah, they're 10 feet wide.
So, yeah.
I need to learn my spells. I want to push him away. Or Arlie, is it... How much chat can I have with Arlie before the attack?
Not much. Remember, your turn is 6 seconds.
Yeah, so like a couple of words. That's about it.
Okay, so I yell out. I'm going to shatter the... G in the spider Arlie. So
okay.
Okay, so you're shattering Arlie again, alright.
No, not Arlie. So it's the spider. So I'm gonna focus it right on top of the spider. So it shouldn't go, so Arlie has a good 5 feet clearance there.
Yeah, I know, but you said spider Arlie, so I was like, okay, you're going to shoot Arlie again.
So my D20 was a 19, and okay, so I got a 19, and then at higher levels, 10-foot radius.
You don't roll anything.
Oh, I don't?
Read your spells.
The creature...
Spider has to make a constitution saving throw.
Okay, there you go.
What's your spell DC? Top of your third page. Spelled, saved,
13.
He saves.
Spell attack bonus plus 5.
So roll 3d8 thunder damage, and it'll take half of that.
3D.
3D8.
Well, the 6, an 8, and a 5. So that's how much?
19, so half of that.
19. Does that roll up or down?
Usually it rolls down. So it takes 9 damage. All right. Anything else?
I want to... I'll move right there. That's all.
Okay. Arlie, you're up.
Yay!
Do what you did last time to the thing's face.
I don't think I can do that to this one again. I am going to Burning Hands the spider.
Okay.
In its face. Wait, Deo broke out of the web, right?
Yeah, yes, Dagon's in one.
Oh, Dagon's in one?
Yep.
But I'm in the way of at least the other one, so if you're able to kill that other spider, we should be okay.
Yeah, that's kind of what I'm thinking here. Alright, 15-foot cone from me. Alright, so that'll work. Yay!
Burn it down the forest.
No, just the spider. He takes up the cone area.
Oh, okay. He's good.
Depending on which way you're pointing your burning hands.
Yeah.
You could get Deo and Dagon.
Wait, no, I'm pointing it directly at Spider 3. Not getting them at all.
Alright.
Alright, so he needs to make a dexterity save, and my DC is 14.
He makes it.
He makes it?
Yep.
Okay.
Spiders are very dexterous.
Just weird. You'd think with all those legs, they wouldn't be.
Yeah, can't we fight some clumsy spiders that just stumble over their legs?
Class.
So he takes 10 points of fire damage.
Okay, he's starting to look a little rough. Anything else on your turn?
I'm also going to cast Shield of Faith again on Dagon this time. Yeah, that's Zagarit's character, right?
You're casting it on Dagon again?
No, not Deo, but...
I said Zagarit. Dagon.
Yeah.
Okay, Shield of Faith fails on Ur-Tok then.
Is it concentration?
Yeah, I believe so. When I read the spell, I'll check again. Yep, concentration up to 10 minutes.
I forgot that. I had just read it, and I totally forgot that.
So, Ur-Tok, you are back to your AC of 13.
She just unbuffed the human shield that she just shielded.
He seemed to have gotten hit really easily. I was trying to help him. but that's it for me.
All right.
So we've got 3 minutes left, right? About
a couple. Yeah. We should be able to finish this fight, hopefully.
Dagon, you're up. You are restrained.
I guess I'm going to try to get out of this web.
Okay. Roll a strength check.
Boom! The gods are messing with me tonight. Natural 20.
Alright, you managed to, like, just wiggle your way out, and then you just, like, and then there's a cocoon right where you were that just collapses.
Oh, crap.
No, that was where you were in.
Oh.
Yes, yeah, you just managed to, like, just, like, completely slip out of the cocoon.
It's
empty inside, and then it finally just collapsed at your feet.
I was like, damn it.
I was like, you want to be still caught in it? What?
And I guess that's my turn.
Okay. Giant spider number 2's turn. Let's see if it gets the webbing back. It does.
Spiders need to be nerfed.
Yeah.
He's gonna come up and he's gonna bite her talk.
Wow, really wish I had that +2 shield.
Oh, and he hits.
What do you roll?
Roll the 12 plus 5 to hit.
Oh, yeah. So it wouldn't matter.
Yeah, you're getting hit either.
You take 10 points of piercing damage. I need you to make a constitution saving throw.
21.
Alright, you take 3 additional points of damage.
3 additional? So 13 total?
Yep, 13 total.
Oh, damn. I thought you said 40 additional for a second. I was like, what?
Okay, if it would have been 40, I'd be like, this thing better be dropping something epic.
Yeah, I was literally having a what?
When we kill this thing, this better have night vision goggles. That's all I'm saying if it took 40 damage.
How much you have left? You're like...
I have 10 hit points left.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, they hit hard.
Yeah, and it's now your turn to ale.
Well, I was going to finish off the other spider, but I don't want an attack of opportunity, so I'm going to attack spider 2.
All right.
20.
Yep, that hits.
And 1d12. Oh, thank God. 12 plus the 13, 17. Yeah. 17 total damage.
Yeah. Alright. You pretty much almost cleaved the thing in half, but it's still alive and it's looking rough.
Oh, man. Well, that's... I think I'll, like... Can I... Is there a bonus action to, like, try to bump it, or would that be an action?
That would be an action.
Okay, then my... Yeah, that's it. So I'll end my turn.
Alright. Giant Spider's 3's turn. Did not get the webbing back. Yeah, he's gonna go after Arlene since she burned him. And he's gonna bite. And he fails. He just, like, gnaws at your armor.
Neener, neener, neener.
Oh, now everybody fails, huh?
Yeah, he rolled a 4. Makes me sad. Robot, you're up.
All right. Alright, so I wish they were closer together so I could shoot them, but so I think GS3 is pretty hurt, so I'm going to try to...
You can basically pick either. They're pretty...
Yeah. I'm going to kill off GS3 with my crossbow, and If I inspire someone else, does Arlie lose inspiration?
No.
I already used it anyway.
Okay, so I'll inspire Dagon because he should be after Arlie. So I'm going to shoot GS3 and inspire Dagon. So let me shoot the fighter. Rolled an 11, plus, what else do I roll? Plus my attack bonus.
Attack bonus.
Is 6, so 17.
You hit.
And
roll for damage.
I rolled 5 plus 4 is 9.
Okay, how do you want to kill spider number 3?
I hope that my bolt shoots it between its body and its legs so that it kind of flops over to the side and without any stability.
Yeah, it does that. Just like the bolt just like cleaves in through the body, like right against like where the legs join the body, and it just like falls to the side. And I keep
you're clear.
And then it just legs all curl up.
And as I do that, I yell at Dagon, "Remember Frodo!" And then I inspire him that way.
Arlie, you're up.
Oh, Arlie was next. So, can I double inspire?
Nope. You inspired Dagon.
No, no, but I mean, could I inspire Arlie and then re-inspire her?
Yeah.
Like, oh, I didn't know.
So long as she doesn't have an inspiration die.
I thought I... anyway, all right, so Dagon.
Anyways, I step over next to Dagon and I cast... wait, not Dagon. Deo. God.
Technically both of us.
Urtok, yes. I'm going to cast Cure Wounds as a second level spell on him.
All right. Roll your healing.
So you get 16 points of health back.
Yay.
Shit.
Yeah, I rolled well on that.
Thank you. Honestly, when I saw your character move over next to me, I was like, oh, she's going to heal me. Then you're like... I'm going to target Dagon. I'm like, you son of a...
No, it's what I meant to do. I just talk past
people. People really like me.
Okay, anything else?
I think that's it, yeah.
Okay. Dagon, you're up.
I'm freaking thrusting some short swords up in this mofo.
Oh, can he, like, do, like, a flip off of me? Like, jump, like, use me as, like, a springboard?
So I'm dual-wielding short swords.
Okay, make your first attack. Which weapon?
I guess the special one.
Okay.
Which I got, let's see, plus 7, 13.
You miss.
Oh, crap.
The spider just, like, backs up really quickly and just whiff air.
It's worth it not.
Make your second attack, since you're wielding light weapons.
This one has disadvantage.
Yep.
Oh, of course.
Inspiration.
That
Remember, you have the inspiration, so you roll a d. You can add a d6 to your attack roll.
Oh. Well, then didn't the first one hit too?
And you pick on which one you want to do.
Oh.
Yeah. And you didn't remember it, so it already happened.
All right. Well, I think this one would have hit anyway, because I have a 20, but not natural 20.
Yeah, that would have hit. You hit it would have hit on the other one if you added the D6, but you forgot about inspiration.
All right, so what do I got? D1d6. Of course, I roll 1 plus 5, so 6.
Okay, you manage to slice like right underneath where all its eyes are, and it's looking pretty rough, but it's still up.
I guess I just gotta end my turn because if I move, it's gonna attack me, right?
Mm-hmm. It's gonna attack you either way. It's up next.
Ah, crap.
And he's gonna bite you.
Ah, crap.
Well, at least you have the +2, so remember that.
Doesn't matter. He fails.
Of course, because they weren't attacking me.
Yeah, I rolled a 3.
Stupid spider.
Unless an 8 hits you.
Nope.
Then yeah, you're fine.
I have 17 with that buff.
Deo, you're up.
It's on like Donkey Kong. All right.
Here comes some crazy grapple.
No. All right, I'm kind of moved to there, and I will swing with my great axe.
Okay.
21.
Yeah, that
hits. All right, and 1d12. 14.
How do you want to kill him?
I want to do like an kind of like an uppercut style thing, like basically swing underhand, cutting it like from the bottom, but like picking it up and like arcing it and slamming it on the other side, like.
Okay, so pretty much you underhand swing it, the axe blade goes. What is it? What are you wielding?
A great axe.
Yeah, okay, that's what I thought. The axe blade just like cleaves like the front half of the spider and launching into the air, and it flips over on the back. And when it lands, the legs curl up on the body. And it's dead.
Let's get our XP and call it a day.
Well, was there any notable loot on him? I doubt it, but...
Spider find sticky webbing. You each gain 150 experience points.
Oh, that puts us at 2608. You know why we had to fight those spiders? We didn't kill the big spider. She created more.
You guys are at what now?
2608, but I think...
24.
Yeah.
2475.
You guys are close to level 4.
So close, but not quite there.
Yep.
Megatron. I have probably about 20 Megatrons.
Of experience?
Of experience points, yeah.
Made it sound like it was a unit of measurement. I have 20 Megatrons.
I want to get that, what's it, the new Link game. I think I should probably just go ahead and buy that thing. It's probably, from the reviews I've seen, it's like early game of the year, but.
Yeah, people are liking it.
Yeah. And it's apparently on the Wii U as well, right?
Yep. Yeah.
So the quality, what's the comparison?
I haven't seen a comparison between the two.
Yeah, probably just poly count, I bet. Maybe quicker load times, I don't know. But I take it we're not continuing since we've hit 11.
Yep.
It's past 11 now.
Yeah. All right. Well, thank you, everybody, for coming out on the to the stream. Thank you, Terran23, for the host. Let's go down the line. Midori, where can they find you? Or any shout out to?
Shout out to Justice Democrats, new progressive party of the Democratic Wing, and Robot Adventures. Like, what the fuck? Alright, go ahead, next.
And Dagon, any shout outs or where can I find you?
I got nothing to follow that with.
And Sariel.
Find me on Twitter at Arlie82. Yay.
And RDM.
Follow me at VTavok on Twitter, though I don't really tweet at all.
This thought that counts. And you can find me at simply_Dale on Twitch, Twitter, and YouTube. If you're interested in Guild Wars 2, we do a Guild Wars 2 podcast. That's twitch.tv/talkingscrit, YouTube, Talking Scrit, all that stuff. And other than that, we'll see everybody this will probably come out on YouTube throughout the week, but we're not doing one next week that's in this realm. I don't know if we'll do a one-off, depending on who's here. But, yeah, I don't know when we'll be doing the next one. But, follow me on Twitter, or one of us probably will tweet out when we do the show or when it goes up on YouTube. So, yep, Twitter's the best way to keep in touch. But, yeah, thank you everybody for coming out. See everybody next time. Bye.